A tradie's most important tool is their multimeter. You can't see, hear, smell, or taste electricity. The only sense you have to detect electricity is the one you shouldn't use. The saying, test before you touch, is there to remind you that electricity is potentially lethal and should always be respected. When selecting a personal multimeter, ensure it has the range of settings required for the work you're undertaking. The quality and safety features of multimeters vary significantly and are usually reflected in the meter's cost. A budget meter designed for hobbyists will not suit the professional electrical worker. Safety rating categories of multimeters range from 1 to 4 at a specified voltage, with category 4 being the highest. This is based on the meter's ability to withstand the potential fault energy it may be subjected to under measurement conditions. For electrical work on low voltage installations, a minimum rating of category 3 at 600 volts is recommended. Whatever multimeter you choose, it is essential that you become very familiar with its operation so you can safely use and maintain the tool correctly without confusion. When setting up a multimeter to measure voltage or resistance, test leads should be located in the correct receptacles for those readings. To take current readings, one test lead is relocated to a test receptacle marked for current. Meters may have one or two of these receptacles for different current ranges, with these being fuse protected. With leads placed for current measurement, the resistance across the meter leads is virtually zero, regardless of any other meter setting. Attempting a voltage reading with a multimeter in this configuration would cause a short circuit, possible meter failure, arc damage, and injury to the user. Always check leads for correct orientation. Most multimeters on the market feature a rotary selector switch that requires the operator to set it for the desired reading parameters. Some meters are auto-ranging. Adjusting measurement values, AC and DC units, and polarity internally after required measurement unit has been set. Semi-automatic multimeters may also have additional auxiliary switching for range settings within the selected unit. A manual set selector switch includes several ranges within the selected unit area. More care needs to be taken in the selection process here. AC and DC units have separate areas on the selector switch. Before taking any readings with a multimeter, you must verify that the meter is operational on the selected scale. This can be done by applying the meter to a known value source before taking any readings of the circuit under test. Once testing has concluded, the meter is verified against the known value source again. This proves that the meter did not fail during the test procedure. When the value of the unit range being measured is unknown, and you are using a manual set meter, set the meter at its highest range first. The meter can be set to a more suitable scale after the first reading, if required. If the value being read is greater than the meter's range setting, an error signal, such as OL, over limit, or the digit 1 will be displayed on the screen. You should never attempt to adjust the selector switch when the meter is in circuit. Always disconnect the meter before making any selector changes. With modern digital displays, unit values on any setting are easily identifiable. Whole numbers and decimals, range settings, polarity, and battery condition are all displayed on the meter's screen. Some meters also incorporate a secondary analog scale as a second reference. Take care of your multimeter. Ensure it is switched off and stored safely when not in use. Test leads should be removed for storage to reduce mechanical stresses. Remember, your multimeter is your most important tool. Always test the tester before and after use, and be a safe electrical worker. Next, watch this video on non-contact current meters and voltage detectors.